After NASA Apollo 11's incredible feat of putting three men on the moon in June of 1969, astronaut Michael Collins said, "All of this is possible only through the blood, sweat, and tears of thousands of people." He said, "All you see are the three of us, but underneath the surface are thousands and thousands of others." According to author Catherine Nemish, there were about 400,000 others who helped with the Apollo 11 mission. Hidden heroes, space suit seamstresses, radio telescope operators, parachute designers, and others made it possible to get men to the moon, to get them home, and to let the rest of the world watch while it happened. At Kennedy Space Center, some 17,000 engineers, mechanics, soldiers, contractors, and other workers set up the enormous missile just for the launch. Team Moon also included a 24-year-old computer whiz kid by the name of Jack Garman. He helped work through the worrisome computer glitches during the Eagle's landing. No wonder astronaut Neil Armstrong would later say, as he took his first step on the moon, he immediately thought about all those 400,000 people who had given him the opportunity to make the first step. Paul rejoiced for special people who helped him along the way. In Philippians 4:1, he says, "Therefore, my brothers and sisters, whom I love, whom I long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, dear friends." Paul discovered in chains, in the blackest prison, that no problem is ever as dark when you have a friend to face it with you. You see, friends light the way. Paul says five incredible things about his friends, the Philippians. First of all, he identifies them as his brothers and sisters. Second, Paul loves the Philippians. He notes that they are bound together in love. Third, he longs for them, meaning he desires to have them near so he can have fellowship with them. Paul calls the Philippians his joy. He believes that life remains better just because he had the chance to know them. They had brought him joyous thoughts as he had waited the trial of his life. And last of all, Paul refers to the Philippians as his crown. He noted that their response to the Lord would give him joy on the judgment day and give him a crown. Crowns refer to his reward. The Philippians were Paul's reward, his crown. Paul had a name for the special people that had graced his life. "Therefore, my brothers and sisters, you whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord." Here it is, his special words, "Dear friends." Paul called them dear friends. Those were the ones who caused him to rejoice. And as Paul rejoiced for people who helped him along the way, he says in Philippians 4:10, "I rejoice greatly in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it." Paul expressed his joy for the Philippians because they gave a gift to him. Now, evidently, some time had passed between their first gift and the second gift. But here is the incredible thing about the Philippians. They never forgot Paul. They truly loved him. When Epaphroditus arrived with their gift the second time, it caused Paul tremendous joy. Paul could rejoice that he wasn't forgotten, even in prison. The giving of his friends made Paul rejoice. Bilkisha Demur of Northern Arizona University, a PhD professor, he notes that companionship, simply doing things together, is the component of friendship that makes us the most happy. He said the reason friends make us happy is that they make us feel, here it is, that we matter. The Philippians made Paul feel like he mattered. And when he wrote his letter to them, they knew they mattered to him. There is nothing in the world like special Christian friends. The body of Christ offers a higher order of belonging and fellowship than the world. Belichick and Saban, in a thing I saw on TV called The Art of Coaching, they begin to share their coaching philosophies. Clearly, in their interview, they are not big fans of social media. Belichick said this, "There are no cell phones on the field. You better know what your teammate's doing, and he better know what you're doing, or, you know, you're going to get beat." Saban said this, "And I think because of social media, they're getting a lot of their positive self-gratification from him without looking somebody in the eye, without developing a relationship with the person they're talking to." And he said this, "I think that's a critical part of what you need to develop, and you need to have a team." Belichick came back. He said, "No question. Who cares how many likes you get from the 2,000 people who don't even know you? There are 53 guys in the locker room. Those are the 53 that matter." And when it comes to life, the community we share as the body of Christ is the thing that matters. And I'll go even a step further. Your special Christian friends are the ones who really matter. They enable you to win the game. They put you on the moon. They bring you joy. Let us, like Paul, rejoice for special friends who have helped us along the way.